Ready? Start. In the judgment of the Kerala High Court, a number of journal directions have been issued to all the criminal courts which are called upon to hold trials, particularly in cases involving an offence under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instruments Act 1881, as also in all other cases involving offences which are technical in nature and do not involve any moral turpitude. In view of the controversy at hand, it is unnecessary to state the facts giving rise to this appeal in detail, except to note that the present case arises out of a complaint filed under Section 138 of the NI Act. On being summoned by the magistrate, the accused preferred a petition before the High Court under Section 482 of the Criminal Procedure Code 1973, inter alia praying for dispensing with her personal appearance before the magistrate. As afore stated, the High Court, while allowing the said application and permitting the accused to appear before the trial court through her counsel, felt that there was great need for rationalizing, humanizing, and simplifying the procedure in criminal courts, with particular emphasis on the attitude to the criminal with no moral turpitude, or the criminal allegedly guilty of only a technical offense, including an offense under Section 138 of the NI Act. Relying on the decision of this court in Bhaskar Industries Limited versus Bhivani Denim Limited and others, and of the Kerala High Court in Shashendra Nair versus Journal Manager, the learned judge has issued the following rules of guidance with a direction that these can and must certainly be followed by the court below in the instant case, as also by all criminal courts which are called upon to deal with trials under Section 138 of the NI Act. Hereafter, in all 138 prosecutions, the very fact that the prosecution is one under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instruments Act shall be reckoned as sufficient reason by all criminal courts to invoke the discretion under Section 205 CRPC, and only a summons under Section 205 CRPC shall be issued by the criminal courts at the first instance. In all pending 138 cases, also applications under Section 205 CRPC shall be allowed, and the accused shall be permitted to appear through their counsel. The plea, whether of guilty or of innocence, can be recorded through counsel duly appointed, and for that purpose personal presence of the accused shall not be insisted. Evidence can be recorded in a trial under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instruments Act in the presence of the counsel, as enabled by Section 273 CRPC, when the accused is exempted from personal appearance, and for that purpose the personal presence of the accused shall not be insisted. Examination under Section 313 CRPC can be dispensed with under the proviso to Section 313, and if the accused files a statement explaining his stand, the same can be received by the court notwithstanding the absence of a provision similar to Section 233 and 243 CRPC in the procedure for trial in a summons case. द पावर एंड द ऑब्लिगेशन टू क्वेश्चन द अक्यूज्ड टू इनेबल हिम टू एक्सप्लेन द सर्कमस्टांसेस अपियरिंग इन एविडेंस अगेंस्ट हिम मस्ट ऑब्लाइज द कोर्ट इन सच सिचुएशन टू एक्सेप्ट एंड कंसीडर द रिटन स्टेटमेंट मेड बाय द अक्यूज्ड To receive the judgment also, it is not necessary or essential to insist on the personal presence of the accused if the sentence is one of fine or the judgment is one of acquittal. After the pronouncement of judgment, the case can be posted to a specific date with directions to the accused to appear in person to undergo the sentence. By that date, it shall of course be open to the accused to get the order of suspension of the superior court produced before court. Where warrants are to be issued in a 138 prosecution ordinarily a bailable warrant under section 88 CRPC must be issued at the first instance before a non-bailable warrant without any stipulations under section 87 CRPC is issued. The above stipulations can only be reckoned as applicable in the ordinary circumstances and are not intended to fetter the discretions of the court to follow any different procedure if there be compelling need. In such event, the orders, directions of the magistrate shall clearly show the specific reasons as to why deviations are resorted to. So any person having a grievance has the option of approaching this court.